So guys, let's place the cooker belts, and this time I'm going to use three of these, okay? One done. Second also done. The final one. Third also done. Yeah. It seems pretty strong. So guys, this is a 1.5 HP DC motor, permanent magnet DC motor, and this is a 12 volts 90 amps car alternator value, okay? Both of them have been mechanically connected through this belt and pulley system. And guys, the motor has been connected to this DC controller. The DC motor controller has been connected to this 220 volts socket. So guys, you have already seen it in my previous video that I self-excited this car alternator and produced 12 volts without any battery excitation or capacitor or DC generator. So using that technique, I am going to generate 220 volts AC from this alternator to run home appliances, which is very important for our house generation, okay? So yeah, let's do that. Everything is same as before. The only difference is that I'm going to convert the output of this alternator, which is 12 volts, to 220 volts with the help of an inverter. Okay, so guys, let's turn on the setup to check if everything is connected properly or not. Yeah, as you can see that the connections are properly made. Now let's connect the inverter to this setup. And guys, this is the 3000 watts inverter, 12 volts to 220 volts, that I'm going to use to power up with this alternator, car alternator. You can see 1 ampere, 2.4 amperes, USB ports plus DC input from the alternator and AC output from this inverter, both have been provided as display. So these are the points where DC input will be provided, plus and minus, and there is also a cooling fan. Link to buy this product will be provided in the description. Okay, so let's connect it with these clips to the alternator. Yeah, so it is pretty tight. So guys, the red terminal from this inverter is going to be connected to this positive terminal of the alternator, and the black terminal is going to be connected to any part of the body of the alternator, like this or this, or even the vice. And to excite the rotor winding for self excitation, it is already connected with this resistor, and a video for self excitation has already been shown in one of my previous videos. Link for that will be provided in the description. So let's connect it. Red positive, okay, and black negative. Okay guys, here as you can see that the connections have been properly made. Negative has been connected to the body of the alternator here as you can see, and positive has been connected to the main B positive terminal of the alternator, and the rotor winding has been connected through brushes to the positive B terminal with the help of resistance excitation. Okay, so let's start it. So guys, there is one important thing that I should tell you, that the car alternator self-excites at a very high RPM, okay? So when it gets self-excited, it generates a very high voltage, somewhere around 20 volts. And because the voltage is high, so the current is also very high, like 30 amps or 40 amps or somewhere around that. So for that reason, I will not be able to self-excite it at high RPM this time. I will have to excite it at low RPM with the help of a small battery, so that the output generated voltage by the alternator is not 20 volts, but between 12 to 15 volts, which is safe to feed the inverter. Okay, so yeah, let's do that. So guys, I'm going to use this 3.7 volts lithium-ion battery for exciting this alternator. Okay, so guys, connecting this green jumper cable to this green terminal feeding the brush, positive brush terminal. Okay, so positive from the battery will be connected to this part, and white terminal will be connected to the body of the alternator as negative to feed the negative terminal of the brush. Okay, so yeah, this has also been connected. Now it's time to turn on the DC motor and supply and start running it, and then quickly connect the battery and then remove it, because once it gets self-excited, we don't need to connect the battery anymore. Okay, so turning it on. You can see that the setup has started running. Now it's time to connect the battery to the alternator and then achieve the self-excitation mode and then turn on the inverter. Okay. You see, it is running perfectly. Okay, so guys, let's touch the battery terminals. White is negative and green is positive. Okay. I believe the speed is not much. Let's increase it. Once again. Yeah guys, it is excited. Now let's turn on the inverter. You see that the inverter has turned on and it is flashing 14.5 volts, the best needed to power up the inverter. That is just great. And it is generating or converting it to 227 volts AC. So 14 volts from the alternator have been converted to 227. Okay, now let's connect some appliances. Now guys, reducing the RPM reduces the voltage generated. Obviously you see 13.7 at present. If I will increase the motor controller speed, the DC input voltage will also increase from the alternator. Okay, you see I'm going to increase it now. I've increased it a little bit and you see it is generating 15 volts DC. That is the max that this inverter can take. Let's reduce it a little bit for safety purposes. Yeah, and now as you can see it is 14 volts. 13.9 or 14 volts and the generated voltage is 227. Now to the socket I have connected this bulb holder. Now let's connect this. Yeah, you see it is 18 watts. Okay, so it is 18 watts LED bulb. I'm going to connect it. I believe the wiring is loose. Yeah, you see that the bulb is glowing perfectly. 12 watts bulb, full potential. And the DC volts have dropped from 14 volts to 12.6 volts. Okay, now let's connect a bigger load like a 100 watts bulb. Okay, so guys, this is the 100 watts bulb that I'm going to connect. Let's hope it works. Whoa, the inverter stopped. I believe I will have to increase the RPM just in case. Increasing the RPM a little bit. Yeah, actually it is really dangerous. I will have to reduce the resistance feeding the rotor because otherwise the generated voltage is going to be very high, which might damage the inverter. So I need fixed voltage and more current output from the alternator. So yeah, let's do that first. Turning it off. Now guys, in my previous video of alternator, many of you asked me to show you the resistance that I'm using to feed the rotor winding. So I'm going to measure it for you. Okay. So as you can see that it is 5.6 ohms. Now I'm going to reduce the resistance even further by decreasing the length of the resistance. Okay. Let's take it up to this. Okay. Now the resistance has decreased. You see I have reduced the length of the resistive wire and the new resistance now is 3.8 ohms. Okay, so let's try with this. Okay, so guys, now I've turned on the motor. So let's turn on the excitation mode. Okay.
Whoa!
The excitation has been achieved at the lowest RPM. Although the generated voltage is only 8.4, which is minimum, but minimum RPM was required to achieve the excitation. Let's do it once again
and increase the RPM.
Oh, finally it is working. 100 watts bulb is glowing. Although the DC input voltage is only 9.9 volts from the alternator, which can be increased from the converter. And also guys, I've added one more belt to improve upon the friction. Initially there were 3 belts and now I have added one more, so in total there are 4 belts now. And the bulb is glowing perfectly. I can increase the illuminance by increasing the RPM of this motor, which in turn will increase the RPM of this alternator, and it is going to generate more current. Let's do that a little bit more. Yeah, now it is generating 10.6 volts. A little more. 11 volts and 220 AC out. So it is providing full power to this 100 watts bulb. So the alternator is working perfectly nice, and this inverter is also very nice. The setup is working pretty good, guys. Now let's move to an even higher load. Okay, let's turn it off. Oh, and I forgot to show you one important thing, guys. As you can see, guys, the resistance wire is red hot this time. You see? Oh, super nice. It is glowing red hot. This indicates that the rotor is getting high current from the armature winding of the alternator. So yeah, the alternator is generating pretty good current and voltage at the resistance value of around 3.8 or 4 ohms, okay? So you can use that much resistance. It's going to work pretty good. So let's remove this and connect another load to it. Now guys, I have this 350 watts drill machine that I'm going to try and operate with this inverter and alternator motor setup. So let's connect it first. Okay, connected. Yeah, this also connected. There is capacitor inside, so for a second it turns on and then turns off. No more current. So anyways, let's turn it on and excite it again. Zero, on, increasing the speed. Yeah, that being done, let's excite it. Green as positive of this 3.7 volts battery and white as negative. Yeah, it is excited. Turning it on. Generated voltage 13.2 volts DC. You can see that it is working. Although it is difficult for it to take 350 watts load, let's increase the RPM to the maximum possible generation. 14.6 and then try it. Okay. Again, it has dropped. 15 volts. Okay. Yeah, still it is dropping. I believe I will have to further reduce the resistance so that more current is fed to the rotor winding of this alternator, because of which it is going to generate more current output then. Okay, so guys, now I'm going to reduce the resistance further. Yeah, then it is going to be too low. So I have added one extra turn. Now let's turn it on and excite it once again.
Zero, on, off. Now comes the battery excitation. Green positive and white negative. And it is excited at the lowest RPM, guys. Let's turn it on. Generated voltage 10.3, increasing it. Oops. The resistance broke.
You see, the resistance wire, it broke off because of high heating. Now guys, I'm going to use this wire as the resistance because I have no other option left. The resistance burned off and the drill machine is not working. So the wire has been connected. Let's check its resistance. And as you can see that it is showing 0.7, almost 1 ohm. And I hope that it does not burn the rotor winding.
Okay, so let's connect it. One to this and the other one to this brush terminal. Okay, and hope that it does not burn out. Now the project is very risky. This might even damage the alternator, but it would be better that it damages this red jumper cable instead of the alternator. That is what I hope. Still, I'm going to try this. Let's turn it on. Zero, off, okay, on. Plus here and minus over here. Sorry, minus here and plus over here. Okay guys, get ready. Whoa, it is self-excited. Please don't burn, please don't burn. Don't burn, don't burn. Yeah, it is very hot. 10.2 volts. And the worst part is that I have to increase the RPM to generate more voltage to feed this inverter. Let's try this anyways. Yeah, it is getting very hot. I will increase the RPM a little bit still. Okay. 10 volts. Still 10. 11.1 volts. I think that is good enough. No, it is still turning off. Yeah, it is very hot. 12.1 volts. A little more. 13 volts. Still turning off. Little more. 14 volts. A little more. Very close now. If this wire survives, the project is going to be success for this drill machine. A little more. And now. And you can see it is working now. Whoa. Pretty good. So feeding more power to the rotor winding generates more current for the inverter to convert, and also the generated voltage increases and more voltage is generated at a reduced RPM. So it is not running it at high RPM, but still it is generating 14.7 volts because the electromagnetism of the rotor is very high. You see, pretty good. Nice. Yeah, it is very hot. It is super hot. Now let's turn it off now, guys. Zero.